The screen is yours, sir.
Mr. Chairman, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, let me join others in thanking the Albanian chairmanship for excellent work in the exceptionally challenging situation of 2020. We have been commemorating this year the 45th anniversary of the Helsinki Final Act and the 30th anniversary of the Paris Charter for a New Europe, two documents of the paramount importance. Today is an occasion for a timely and needed reflection, an occasion for tackling the essential question, are we able to live up to the legacy of both documents? Unfortunately, the overall picture we face today is quite far from the visions shared and agreed in Helsinki and Paris. Use of force, violation of OSCE commitments and principles, deepening unpredictability and mistrust belong to the nowadays reality. And I would like to stress again that there is no other solution than strict adherence to a rules-based order, international law, and OSCE principles and commitments. There is no other way than all 57 participating states acting in accordance with all their commitments and obligations, all of them being part of the solution and not the cause of the problem, a role deliberately and repeatedly chosen by one participating state. The situation in Belarus remains extremely worrying. We urge the government of the Belarus to stop the violence towards their own population, including mass detentions of peaceful protesters. Dialogue needs to be start immediately and continue in line with the OSCE rapporteur's recommendations. Regarding the conflict in eastern Ukraine, we are encouraged by the substantial decrease of ceasefire violations since July 2020. On the other hand, we are concerned that this positive environment on the ground has not translated into the political settlement of the conflict yet. Therefore, we support the enlargement of the SMM mandate so that it includes a border control task alongside the Ukraine-Russian border in order to create conditions conducive to elections and political settlement. We applaud the willingness and strategic patience of Ukraine in pursuing the resolution of the Donbas conflict on the basis of the Minsk agreement. We recall our unwavering support to the sovereignty, territorial integrity, unity, and independence of Ukraine within its internationally recognized borders, including Crimea and the city of Sevastopol. We welcome the recent cessation of hostilities in Nagorno-Karabakh, which has prevented further loss of lives. We hope that a political settlement of this long conflict will soon be reached with the support of the Minsk Group and its co-chairs. As for the continuing occupation of parts of Georgia, we call on Russia to fulfill its obligations under the 2008 ceasefire agreement. Our common work in the OSCE this year has been even more challenging due to the impact of COVID-19 pandemic and also by an institutional challenge, namely the process of nomination of four highest OSCE representatives. We warmly welcome that we have been able to overcome an institutional crisis. I'm confident that the selected personalities will contribute within their mandate to an effective and well-functioning OSCE. I praise the Albanian chairmanship for its leadership and very able handling of the whole process. We remain committed to the implementation of arms control and CSBM mechanisms, which are part of the OSCE wider acquis, the CFE, the Open Skies Treaty, and the Vienna document. We regret in this regard that we could not move faster and farther in negotiating the modernization of the Vienna document, also with regards to a new comprehensive proposal of 34 participating states tabled during the Czech FSC chairmanship at the end of 2019. I'm convinced much greater attention should be paid to economic and environmental cooperation, which Prague has traditionally supported by hosting the 28th Annual Economic and Environmental Forum. Last year, we proudly joined the OSCE informal group of friends on environment established at this forum. Promoting respect for human rights and fundamental freedoms represents a long-standing priority of the Czech foreign policy. Czechia contributes to these efforts in an active, trusted and consistent manner, including in the OSCE. We have followed this approach within our work in the OSCE Human Dimension Committee, while continuing focusing on human rights and fundamental freedoms, as well as on the important topic of tolerance and non-discrimination, in line with the priorities of the Albanian OSCE chairmanship and the OSCE. It has been a great honor for my country to chair the Human Rights Human Dimension Committee for the second consecutive year, working closely with the Albanian chairmanship and facilitating ministerial council deliverables in the human dimension under the leadership of Ambassador Sharmik. We further reiterate our steadfast support to the OSCE autonomous institutions, including the Office for Democratic Institutions and Human Rights, Representative on Freedom of Media, and High Commissioner on National Minorities. We strongly reject attempts to undermine their respective mandates and independence. We also regret that the HIDIM could not take place this year. We must preserve the Human Dimension meetings as a venue for open dialogue for all stakeholders. We welcome the adoption of proposals related to the human dimension. I'm personally glad that the Czech Republic could contribute to brokering agreement on one of them as the chair of the Human Dimension Committee. I hope that it is a landmark that confirms the will of all participating states to continue our work in a spirit of cooperation in the coming months and years. In conclusion, I would like to wish the upcoming Swedish chairpersonship as all the success in 2021, and also appreciate Poland being ready for 2022. I would like to welcome also the announced intentions of North Macedonia and Estonia to assume the OSCE chairmanships in following years. Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, sir.